Welcome, my name is Ian Gilfillan from the MariaDB Foundation, and this video looks at authentication from MariaDB 10.4. So what's changed with how you connect to MariaDB since the older releases? Note that the Unix Socket Authentication plugin, which is discussed here, is not available on Windows, so this is mostly applicable to Unix-like systems. Now, all the versions of MariaDB by default were using the MySQL native password authentication plugin. The big change with 10.4 is that it uses Unix Socket authentication by default when you begin. This has been around a while. It was pioneered by Otto Kekäläinen on Debian systems back in since MariaDB 10.0, but from 10.4 it's now in all other distros as well. So Unix Socket Authentication allows, in this case the root at localhost user, to log in without a password via the local Unix Socket file, which is defined by the socket system variable, as long as the login is attempted from a process owned by that operating system root user account. So let's see how this works. Firstly, we start to connect. Now, if the usage you see here, the MariaDB client, is unfamiliar to you, another change from 10.4 is that there are now symlinks to all of the old MySQL binaries have a MariaDB equivalent symlink. And in fact, from 10.5, the reverse applies, where the symlink is now the MySQL version and the MariaDB name is the actual name of the file. So all of the old clients will still work for the foreseeable future, but it's a good habit to get into to start using the MariaDB names. So we will start to try and connect. This is a brand new 10.4 installation, and we start to try and connect. We would do something like user root, password, and then we realize, oh, hang on, I haven't set a password yet. Maybe I forgot it, or maybe the system didn't prompt me and you start to get cross with MariaDB. Actually, you weren't prompted for a password. You no longer need to be bugged to set a password upon installation because you don't need one. Now, if you just try to connect like this, you get access denied. And that is because I'm not the correct user. I'm logging in here as Ian. If I was logging in from the root user, Unix root user, I don't even need to specify the user because I am root. I can log in fine without a password. Now, when people first come across this concept, sometimes they worry about security. They think surely logging in with no password is insecure. No, as we saw here, it doesn't mean just anybody can log in. You have to log in from the correct process. And yeah, if you're trying to log in as root and you have root access, you have a lot more to worry about than just your MariaDB database. So now I'm in. It also means, of course, that there's no need for any config files lying around with plain text passwords, which is another security improvement. Now, 10.4 allows users to have multiple authentication plugins. So by default, we use the Unix Socket authentication plugin here, but let me just show you effectively. Get out of here first. This is effectively what's created upon a new installation. There's a root user and there's a MySQL user, identified via Unix Socket, so that's what we just saw. Or the alternative, and still active, is the MySQL native password authentication, like in the old way of doing things, except that here, the password that's been specified is invalid, which is not a valid, not surprisingly, not a valid password hash. So you can't log in with a password by default, but the plugin is set and you're able to set your own password if you do want to do that. So let's try and create a new user now that can log in and connect with both these methods. So we're creating a new user, Ian. Ian at localhost, identified by a Unix socket or MySQL native password using the password pwd. So now we can log in using Unix socket. No password needed. No username, of course, because I am Ian in this particular instance. No problem there. If I try and log in from any other account, say root account, my access is denied. But I can log in with the password from any other account. So there I am. I'm able to access MariaDB through both authentication plugins. The possible use case for using more than one authentication plugin is perhaps you want to migrate users to a more secure, say the more secure ED25519 authentication plugin, and at the same time still allow users to access MariaDB using the old MySQL native password plugin for a transitional period. And this is now possible from MariaDB 10.4. So what if you want to go back to the old ways? All this new stuff's too much for you. You just want to go back to how it was, password login only. You can, of course, use an alter statement and change rooted localhost identified via MySQL native password using a password pwd. You can see that there was no mention of Unix socket, so that's been completely removed now, and you're only able to log in the old way using password. We can test this, of course. We go back, we try and log in without a password. No go. We can log in from any Unix account, it doesn't matter, with our password, and we're in. No more Unix socket authentication. Now, of course, here you're at risk of forgetting your password again, so there are countless tutorials on the internet about how to restore access once you've forgotten your root password. So we'll tack one on here just for good measure, because there's a small change in the process as well. So let's see how we would get in. We've now lost our password. We can't log into MariaDB. What can we do? So the first step is to restart MariaDB with skip grant tables option. So I've already set that up, and we've restarted MariaDB. Now we can log in without a password, and we're in. We run flush privileges, and now the final step, which wasn't necessary beforehand but it is necessary now from 10.4, is that you need to set a password at this point in time for your root user. So we can set password for rooted localhost equals password new. Now we have our password remembered again, and we can log in with the password new, and we're in. We've restored access. So there are a number of other changes from 10.4 that are not being covered in this video. For example, the mysql.user is no longer a table, it's actually a view, and it's created from the mysql.globalprov table. No need to worry, because all of your old tools that still access or try and read mysql.user should continue to work as before. The main reason for doing it is that MySQL.user couldn't show alternative authentication plugins. It couldn't handle complex authentication rules, hence the need to switch to MySQL.globalprov. Any questions, you're welcome to ask in the YouTube comments, and there will be links below to relevant pages on the knowledge base. Thanks for watching. Till next time.